Welcome back everyone to Babes Art Class. So it is so hot here in the Northeast today. We're in Rhode Island here, Babes Art Class, and it's stifling out, but I really wanted to do this new video for you. And you can see in my background, I changed out my gallery a little bit just to show you some more pieces. And today I'm going to be doing a gorgeous split base with a bunch of colors. I'll go over the colors as I do them. And so let's get started. And I'm using a 16 by 20 canvas, which is fairly large. And I already put on the white half of the base coat. I just troweled it on. And now I'm gonna put on the ultramarine part of the base coat. I'm just going to follow along this edge that I already made with the white. And then I'm just going to kind of fill in, and I'm going to trowel it on. I'm going to mix it with the trowel. And I love this ultramarine color because it's so rich. The ultramarine, I just take from my fine art paints and mix it the way I do all my other paints. I mix it one part acrylic paint to two parts floetrol to a half a part of water. And I like to trowel on when I can, because I don't think you waste as much paint, and it's definitely not as messy. So that's almost done. And it doesn't have to be perfect, because we're going to be covering it with lots of paint. I need to move over the little stand I have underneath it. Okay. All right, so I'm gonna start with this gorgeous color. It's metallic cobalt blue, and like I said before, it looks to me like it's teal. That's what they call it, and I'm going to draw a line down that center line between the white and the ultramarine. Then I'm going to go over it with aqua green, which is one of my favorite colors. I'm not going to go over the whole thing, but I'm going to put some of it on here and there. And then I'm going to start to lay on this, which is also another favorite color, and it's really just the aqua green mixed with some white, and it's gorgeous. I'm going to do some puddles. Puddles of the aquamarine, and I think that I'm also going to just bring it down a little bit, down a little bit here. And on top of the aqua green, we're going to put some pink. Okay, we have some pink. Then I'm also going to do a couple puddles of yellow. And this is a little clogged, so we'll use the trusty skewer stick and go right into the bottle and get out that clog. No clogs allowed. All right. So we'll put some yellow. Going to add a little orange. You have to be careful what you put orange next to, because orange doesn't always look good next to other colors like green and blue. What I mean is mixing with other colors. It can be very pretty next to them, just not mixing. We'll put a little gold on everything. And I'm going to put a little bit of this gorgeous green . This is color fusion, color shifting, I should say. It actually changes colors. Let's see how I'm gonna do this. I'm gonna put some down here, over here, up here. With that, I think we'll put a little more of this aqua green. Okay. See what else do I think we're going to need. We're definitely going to need to flood this area. So with the blue, and we'll flood this with the white. That'll make it flow better. And I'm thinking I'm gonna put another puddle up here. Going to need another puddle up here. Pink. And gold. And we'll flood that also. So let's get started. I'm going to start with the hairdryer on low. So what I'm doing is I'm adding some more color where color kind of peeked out on me. And we'll redo that part and this part. That's the thing with this type of painting. You can always fix things. Alright, let me see what we need to do to this. This is very colorful. Just need some more background color in there. A little more here. And here. Really like this up here, so I'm going to take it out. Take it right out. I like the color. But not the composition of that. Drop in some more white. All And that's why I say you can fix anything. And we'll see if we can fix that out a little more. Okay, so we certainly have a lot going on here. So right here. I'm going to get out my airbrush. And just do a little bit of last minute details. And turn this a little bit. Looks like a big fan in through here. Kind of looks like an underwater paradise of coral. Yes, I definitely see a lot of coral in this one. All different colors. Just any little place you need a little more interest. You can use an airbrush, you can use your straw. The funny thing about this airbrush is it was actually an airbrush for makeup. I didn't really like it for that purpose. I didn't care for it. So I said, why don't I try it in my artwork? And I think this is gorgeous. There's lots of cells going on down here.